Hi, y'all. Welcome to another wonderful WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton here at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas. Today for WordPress Wednesday, we are going to walk through, we're going to go back to the total basics, how to set up your homepage with static content and how to say where you want your blog articles to appear inside of your website. It's a simple thing, but if nobody's ever showed you, it can be very confusing. Before I get started, you know what I have to do? I've got to give a shout out to our amazing sponsors and partners in crime. And helping you with the WordPress world, all right? WP Engine is incredible hosting. They have staging sites for you, so if you want to tinker and play around with your website and don't want to mess up what the live version looks like, you can get a staging site with their incredible hosting service. Check them out. We also have WP Elevation. If you're an entrepreneur using WordPress, if you're a small business owner or a freelancer for that matter, using WordPress to make a living, you need to check out their tracks. Troy is an incredible guy. He's from Australia, so he's got a great accent, fun to listen to, not bad to look at either. And WP 101, another great company doing amazing WordPress videos. He slows down. He doesn't talk nearly as quickly as I do. And he gives you step-by-step, beautiful, clear instructions on how to use WordPress better. So check out their, they have free videos as well as a wonderful paid environment that you can get into and really find some dynamic, cool videos. Let's talk about setting up your homepage. How do you do it? If by default, let's go back for a second. By default, WordPress thinks that you want to use your website for a blog. And that's not always the case. Sometimes you want to have a blog inside of it, but it would be nice to go ahead and have maybe a welcome paragraph or something on the homepage that folks can read, and it's just more static, and then maybe you want them to click somewhere else to get to your blog area, right? So how do we do that? I'm gonna walk you through where those settings are inside of WordPress. You're gonna log into your dashboard. On the left side of your navigation over here, you've got an area called settings, all right? You'll go into reading. Now, you've got an option right up here. This says front page displays, and it's basically asking what do you want to display on your front page of your website. By default, this option is typically selected, your latest post. So it thinks again that you want to use this website for a blog. So by default, when I go to my homepage on wpwd.com, wordpresswednesday.com, we have all of our posts or all of our helpful tutorial videos sitting here, right? But if I just wanted a static bit of information to sit there, maybe a welcome area, I can actually click this option, and then these two selections are become available for me. I can open this up, and I can choose home page. Now, you would have had to already make that page, okay? And I have already made a home page, and I just put one line of content just specifically for this tutorial. But if I select home page, I can go ahead and click save changes. Now, when I go back to the front side of my website and click refresh, WordPress knows to not display all of my posts. Those are gone. And now it just displays whatever I had inside of that page. So when I go to all pages here, you can see in my home page here that I only have all of our content. That's the one line I have sitting there. And of course, that's visible here. So you could put obviously anything you wanted into this space, fill it up, put some images, put a video if you wanted to, whatever you wanted, and click publish or update, and now this could be your homepage content. The other thing that some authors might give you an option for to designate what your homepage is actually sitting inside of this template area. So if doing what I just told you does not work, you have two other potential options. You can come into your homepage area like this, create your page, and check and see if your author has given you some sort of a template option over here that might have a drop-down option that says home page. Then that's the way the author has designated you to set your content on your home page. Your second option that I want to remind you of is look at the documentation. Every theme out there, especially if it's a premium theme that you've purchased, should have incredible documentation from the author. So inside that zipped file that you originally downloaded, dive back in there, open it up, and see if you can find anything in there that says documentation or how-tos or read me first. If you can click on that, you should be able to find a step-by-step instructional guide on how to set up, install, set up, import demo content maybe, how to use their short code system. Some authors give you so much love in there. It's incredible. And they really walk you through everything step by step by step. So that's how you would set up your homepage to static content. What if I wanted a page now in my menu? Let's say up at the top up here. Let's go back. I'm going to slide over here. I'm going to slide out of the way for a second. What if I wanted up here at the top of my menu area to have a link that says blog now that I don't want it on my homepage, but I do want it accessible? Well, you would come in here and click Add New, and we would simply just create a page called blog or resources or whatever you'd want that to be. And then you just click Publish. You wouldn't put anything inside here. Just go ahead and click Publish. And now we have a page designated for the articles to dynamically display, but there's one more step. You still have to go into Settings, go back to Reading, and see this? It says Post Page. Now, because I've already made that page, I can choose Blog and click Save. But that's still not up in my main menu, so I've got to go add that. So I'm going to go into Appearance, go to Menus. I'm going to be sure I'm on the correct menu, which is my main menu at the top of my website. So now I've got my blog page over here. I can click Add to Menu. And maybe I want that to be my second option, so I drag and drop it and click Save Menu. Now when I go back to the front side of my website and click Refresh, my second option should be Blog. When I click on there, all of my posts should dynamically display now, just like they originally did on my home page. How groovy cool is that? And of course, inside of that settings reading area, you can kind of designate, do you want it to be full text, meaning do you want the entire article to display on that really long page, or do you just want maybe a snippet or a summary that offers the read more option where they can click in and go to the actual post or article and read the whole darn thing over there, right? You can also designate how many you want to display on one page at a time. So if you're doing like what I'm doing with our blog post, I could potentially say I want 20 because I really don't write text. I just have videos sitting there. So it would be incredible to have a lot of videos on one page. I typically leave this at 10. And as y'all saw earlier, I always have my posts on my homepage. So I'm going to set everything back here, click Save Changes, and I'll go through and take that off the menu. I hope that helped y'all. If y'all have questions about your WordPress website, would you consider putting them in the description box below or tweet us? That's always an option. I'll put our Twitter handle in the description box below. And we'll catch y'all next WordPress Wednesday. Thanks so much. Bye-bye, y'all.